everybody, and welcome to this week's On the Horizon from HorizonHobby.com. I am Gary Katzer, site content specialist for surface products here on HorizonHobby.com. We have news for you this week from Force, from HPI Racing, and from Traxxas. So let's get started. From Force, this week is a new combo available from Force RC. And you guys have seen these helicopters now for about a year, and what's neat about these is it kind of takes the flight experience of the Blade MCX and MCX2 and adds a game factor to it. By that I mean the Force helicopters have these really cool LED guns on them where you can play like capture the flag or try to shoot your friends down or things along those lines with these Force combat helicopters. Now this new combo includes one of each different canopy style. It includes two transmitters and two battery packs. This is absolutely a great way to get involved in RC flying, and it teaches you a lot of the basics, and it's still got all the great features that the Force helicopters have been known for. It's designed around the MCX and the MCX2 platform, so you already know it's a great, easy to fly coaxial helicopter. It also has that simple fly mode in here too to help the even real the basic beginners get up and flying and be able to enjoy their helicopter experience as much as possible. Now this week we also have news on the surface side from HPI Racing and from Traxxas. HPI Racing has gone ahead and they've updated their popular Blitz ESE chassis and added in a ton of new features on there. The new version of the Blitz ESE comes with the Attack 10 body and now includes an MIP ball diff. They've also gone ahead and redesigned and improved the matte black MK8 V2 short course wheel, which features a flat inner profile and is designed to use a single inner foam insert versus the original wheels, which had that 2.2 by 3 inch type design. This new version of the Blitz ESE also includes Beams tires from Hot Bodies Racing and their winning pink compound tires. These are a very good tire on very hard packed tracks. It also has a lot of the same features that you've come to know, love, and enjoy on the Blitz ESE. The gorgeous shocks return, as do titanium turnbuckles, and it also has that really gnarly looking motor heat sink for the motor mount plate on there too. It's very neat design. Nice to see HPI Racing updating this very popular kit out there. And yes, it still does have all those the beautiful white molded composite parts. Finally, this week from Traxxas, for you Kyle Busch fans out there, you might know that Kyle is out there running the number 18 truck in the Camping World Truck Series with Traxxas sponsorship on it. Well, to kind of help take advantage of their deal that they have with KBR, Traxxas has come out with a 1/16 scale replica of Kyle Busch's Traxxas Camping World Truck Series truck. Out of the box, the Traxxas 1/16 scale Kyle Busch Camping World Series truck racing truck is designed to look and mimic the feel of the same truck that Kyle raced at Chicagoland, Talladega, and Homestead with the Traxxas sponsorship, where he took the checkered flag every time that he ran this paint scheme on there. This is a four-wheel drive chassis that makes it really easy to get out there and enjoy just running. It features a Valenian brushless motor system. It comes with a battery pack and battery charger, sealed waterproof electronics, plus one of the things we're going to give you a closer look here, the wheels on this truck are absolutely stunning. It's an authentic recreation of the Goodyear Wrangler tires that they run in the Camping World Truck Series. It also includes a TQ 2.4 gigahertz radio system with Traxxas Link, comes with a Titan 550 brush motor as another option out there for you guys too. The chassis itself is designed around the Mini E-Revo that's out there. You're going to get that cantilever front and rear suspension on there. Very low center of gravity. It's going to be an efficient drivetrain. Look for this truck very soon. And you guys have seen the pictures. It's a very authentic recreation of this officially licensed truck. Now it's time to head to the workbench for our tips from the workbench. So take care and have some fun with hobbies. Oh, hey guys, welcome to this week's tip from the workbench. As you see, we just got finished recording this week's RC Cast podcast, and you know, it's time to take a break and enjoy this hobby that we have here. So I've got my DX6i here, and I've got the little mosquito here that I'm going to go out and I'm going to enjoy. But it's really a hot day. So our tip today from the workbench is not, we've talked to you guys about how to protect your batteries, how to protect your tools, and how to protect your gear. Today we're going to talk to you about protecting yourself when you're out there flying or driving. It's nearly 95 degrees out there today. Hot one for mid-May. Now, what I'm going to go out and do when I go out and fly this is I'm going to make sure, well, you know, not a whole lot up here. Some people say not a lot up in here either. Anyways, not a lot up here, and I'm fairly fair skinned, and I need to protect myself, and you guys should too. So one of the things is we've got a number of different branded hats. Like I've got my Team TLR hat here. I'm going to go ahead and be wearing when I'm out flying. I'm going to make sure that I use a good high SPF suntan lotion when I'm out there flying. And in addition to protecting my head, I've also got my sunglasses here to help protect my eyes too. Now for you guys that are going to be out there driving and working outside, some kind of a canopy or shade or things like that will absolutely help protect you as well. Helps keep the dirt and dust and things like that from blowing all over your stuff too, especially on your pit tables. So make sure that when you're out there, especially with the summer months coming up upon us, that you protect yourself. And, well, you can also help advertise your favorite brands that are out there too. Well, that will do it for this week's episode of On the Horizon. Thank you all for coming by and watching. Do admit it was a bit of a light week. Look for more information coming out from us soon. Don't forget you can also follow us each and every week online by subscribing to our weekly podcast that we have. It's available for download from iTunes, from the Zune Marketplace, or right on horizonhobby.com. It's called the RC Cast, and you can check us out each and every week on there. This week we are visiting with Kevin Wilson from Force to talk more about this new combo from Force helicopters. Thank you all for watching. We'll see you next week. Now go out and have some fun with hobbies.